Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. For better or worse, everyone knows the story of what happened to the OG Aunt Vivian from the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, but very few, it seems, know the tragic real-life story of Janet Hubert, the talented actor and Broadway star behind the character. Having grown up in the hardscrabble streets of Chicago's South Side, according to her perfection, is not a sitcom mom. Autobiography. Hubert had to work harder than most to claim space for herself within the entertainment industry, as reported by the Los Angeles Times. The young star studied acting on the full scholarship at Juilliard, one of the most prestigious performing arts school in the world. In the meantime, she supported herself during hard times by working at Dunkin' Donuts, having grown up in the working class household with a mom who supported the family by cooking and cleaning houses. These are all details that became lost within the tabloid frenzy of the ongoing feud between herself and Fresh Prince star Will Smith. But they are also personal details that Hubert potentially felt protective of. However, she still shared some glimpses into her personal life and her private battles over the years. So throw on your boldest power outfit and be sure to show some serious respect. Janet Hubert's story demands it. Aunt Vivian radical makeover in the fourth season of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air reintroduced audiences to a new actor depicting the beloved character. Janet Hubert was out and Daphne Reid was in. For years, the story held that the woman who depicted the OG Aunt Viv was fired, but the truth was reportedly a great deal more troubling. Hubert felt forced out of the show due to contractual issues. In an interview with ABC7, the veteran star suggested that amid her real-life pregnancy and difficulties on the set of Fresh Prince, she was offered a terrible contract offer which she viewed as an attempt to put her in her place. Hubert explained, "They offered me 10 weeks of work and they said you can't work anywhere else." Understandably, the Broadway star felt degraded by the negotiation attempt. "We were a very successful show and I felt like I was an integral part of that," she told the crew. "Felt valuable, but you can't feel valuable in Hollywood." At the end of the 1993, Hubert filed a lawsuit against the show's star Will Smith for unspecified damages including defamation and infliction of emotional distress, per the Chicago Tribune. The newspaper reported that the actor-musician influenced NBC to reduce Hubert's salary and airtime, with Hubert alleging that Smith had hurt her marketability by spreading rumors about her behavior. She lost the lawsuit, but arguably her battle was just beginning. As if the contract negotiations were not insulting enough, Janet Hubert's exit from Fresh Prince was treated like one big joke. On the show, the new Aunt Viv was introduced with a sly quip about there being something different about the character since giving birth at the end of the season 3. Meanwhile, Hubert alleged on-set behavior was treated like a real-life punchline. As reported by the Chicago Tribune, Hubert claimed that Will Smith used talk show appearances to suggest his former co-star would flip him the bird and storm off the set. Meanwhile, Perez Hilton published a clip of Alfonso Ribeiro performing a stand-up comedy set in 2009 where he claimed Hubert was fired after making it very difficult for us to work. Due to her supposed behavior, she went nuts, he told the crowd. He would literally go off on people. Hubert was not having it. Speaking to the crew, the star alleged that Ribeiro went out to a college and told a lot of lies with his stand-up sets. "But the problem is I have proof that a lot of that didn't happen." Sadly, solid proof never quite materialized and Hubert's career seemed irrevocably damaged by the allegations, which the actor claimed to ABC7 the cast was offered money to do. She mused, "Everyone in Hollywood is about that check." Unfortunately for Hubert, her bad reputation would
While the rest of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air cast claimed that Janet Hubert was difficult to work with, the actress suggested she was not exactly treated well on set either. In an interview with ABC7, she even alleged that she was pushed aside for not responding adequately to Will Smith's humor. She said, "They told me I had to go into a dressing room in between takes because I was not laughing at Will's joke." To the industry, there was only one side of the story being listened to, the one that implicated Hubert as a diva. Professionally, it pretty much ruined her. She spent the rest of her career having to fight against an illegally falsified reputation which she claimed was not earned or true, while Hubert was a guest on The Real in 2016. She maintained that she was never difficult and was so professional it was not even funny. Tragically, she even claimed to have begged Smith to tell the world that this stuff didn't happen back in 2009. It didn't happen. Thankfully, by 2020, Smith and Hubert finally made peace at HBO Max 2020 Fresh Prince reunion, where she explained the devastating impact of his words against her. She explained, "I lost everything," and described how calling a black woman difficult in Hollywood is the kiss of death. But the impact Smith's words had on Hubert's life and career were for worse than people may have realized at the time. During the Fresh Prince reunion, Janet Hubert opened up to Will Smith about the hurt she felt upon leaving the show. Her entire support system had been destroyed and she felt completely isolated. My family disowned me, she explained. Hollywood disowned me, she previously stated. She felt as though she had been blacklisted from the industry per the Los Angeles Times, and the more she tried to tell her side of the story, the more she found herself silenced. In 2018, for instance, Hubert took to social media to allege how the media wrote about her and why, suggesting she had waited 27 years for Smith to be man enough to admit how he had lied about her. She claimed that his influence and that of his wife Jada Pinkett Smith had further poisoned people against her, including Oprah Winfrey. Even time I tried to call Oprah for help, Oprah's people would say no, she's friends with Will and Jada, so Janet can never be on the show, Hubert alleged time and again. Hubert attempted to address the apparently false narrative surrounding her Hollywood mythology in a bid to redirect and reclaim her career, only to feel punished for it. However, she had no regrets. She told the Los Angeles Times, "I am not afraid to speak the truth. I will take the hit." In doing so, sadly, it appears not many people took her seriously until the Fresh Prince reunion in 2020, when Smith publicly apologized to the star. Despite being so outspoken regarding industry issues and times where she is felt wrong, Janet Hubert has mostly maintained privacy regarding her personal life. So when she chose to speak on the trouble she endured behind the scenes of her time on the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, audiences were shocked to discover the extent of her circumstances. The actor told Smith that there was some friction because of her pregnancy, but there was an additional factor for her suddenly withdrawn behavior on set. She was experiencing a very abusive marriage at home. I was no longer laughing, smiling, joking, because there were things that were going on that nobody knew about, she explained. I was going through a lot at home. You didn't know. Clearly, Hubert didn't feel comfortable with sharing her personal issues with her workplace or with the media, but sadly, Hollywood is not an industry which always grants such privacy or compassion to its stars. In a Radio Andy interview following the series reunion special, Hubert reflected on how public figures are used like dartboards to be talking shoots at, and often without people knowing or understanding the whole story. The actor suggested that her own situation be considered a cautionary tale for others and encouraged the media to be more careful on what stories they report and how, because you don't know. The actor suggested that her own situation be considered a cautionary tale for others and encouraged the media to be more careful on what stories they report and how, because you don't know what's going on behind the scenes with people's lives.
Exit from Fresh Prince and the damage done to her reputation following it had a grave impact on Janet Hubert's financial situation. Speaking to Pop viewers in 2021, the star outlined how juggling her domestic responsibilities, paying a mortgage, raising a newborn baby, and supporting an unemployed husband on top of maintaining a business was so hard on her that she even contemplated suicide. "There were moments where I wanted to die," she confessed. "I figured I had a life insurance policy to take care of my son." Thankfully, Hubert managed to make it through, but it was not easy. In a 2016 interview with the Los Angeles Times, she described how she was left penniless, homeless, and worthless following Fresh Prince, and that she even struggled to feed her child. Her situation worsened when she was forced to rent out her home to a couple who apparently completely mistreated the residents. According to the AV Club, who recapped parts of Hubert's 2009 autobiography, Perfection Is Not a Sitcom Mom, the star confronted her tetans on their treatment of her home, and they pulled a gun on the actor. Hubert subsequently pulled out a pistol in self-defense and ended up getting arrested for it. Hubert was sentenced to community service, which she carried out while still getting asked for autographs. Her Fresh Prince legacy seemingly haunted her wherever she went. Having repeatedly claimed that her career was destroyed by the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, it was difficult for Janet Hubert to move on from the show as quickly or as tidily as she wanted to. Like a lingering spirit that can't be vanquished until it finds closure, the actor had unfinished business with the comedy series and she could not move on until she could clear her name. Unfortunately, nobody but Hubert seemed to be interested in helping, and over time it wore her down. Speaking to the Los Angeles Times, the sitcom icon propounded that she was forced to deal with old stuff from the show every day of her life. Telling the publication, "Every time I try to move forward, somebody brings up Fresh Prince," Hubert added, "I have dealt with the ramifications of rumor about being difficult on the Fresh Prince set and I am tired." And if proving her point entirely, the AV Club wrote a piece about the actress' autobiography in which they appeared to criticize Hubert's desire to rectify her reputation while seemingly attempted to cash in on her own unfortunate legacy. "Business is business," they wrote. And the Fresh Prince name means money even to the woman who probably hates the Fresh Prince more than anyone in the world. Tragically, some members of the media appeared to relish any opportunity to drag and belittle Janet Hubert for decades after the Fresh Prince drama first appeared. In the same AV Club piece criticizing the star's autobiography, for instance, writer Nathan Rabin voiced an an opinion that many outlets seem to share. This woman was a diva who loudly broadcast her lack of respect for Will Smith along with her Juliet pedigree. The problem, Rebin argued, was that Smith, young and inexperienced, simply had its own way of doing things, while Hubert was supposedly a demanding professional stepping on his toes. Hubert was so often painted as a villain in this way that she made it her business to clap back and stand up for herself whenever his depiction surfaced. In 2013, for instance, she wrote What Complex Desire as a really angry letter to Wendy Williams after the TV show host pushed for Fresh Prince star Tatiana Ali to dish some dirt on Hubert's illegal on-set behavior among the barbs thrown at Williams. Hubert accused the host of spewing vulgarity and ugliness and hatred on her show and of attempting to destroy the hard work she had done.
It was an issue that the star raised while on Radio Andy, wherein she suggested that people had a great time demanding her reputation.
Hubert reasoned, sadly, this is what we do to black women and this is what we do to people. Unfortunately, Janet Hubert has experienced various health issues for almost 2 decades. While appearing on The Doctors in 2016, the actor explained how for 12 years she suffered from what's known as military neck, a rare condition that Healthline defines as an abnormal curve of the cervical spine, which can cause a variety of debilitating symptoms. For Hubert, that meant experiencing things like a violent, intense pain accompanied by tremors and dizziness, all of which worsened to the point that she blacked out and was hospitalized. In her emotional testimony on the show, the star revealed she went through 48 different doctors before she was able to find answers and solutions for her symptoms. Tragically, the condition left her unable to work, and in 2014, she filed a lawsuit against her insurer to cover her treatment. She claimed to Radar, "They have sort of denied me some very important medical things that I need," noting, "I would like my benefits back." As reported by the Jasmine brand, she sadly lost her couple battle. She lost her court battle for medical coverage. In 2002, Hubert had already been diagnosed with osteoporosis despite her not fitting the criteria for the disease. The actor's doctor was reportedly even more shocked than she was at the diagnosis, as she was otherwise healthy at the time per her. The star has since worked as an ambassador for the National Osteoporosis Foundation and was even the recipient of their Champion Award in 2005. As an outspoken and proud African-American artist, Janet Hubert has always been vocal about calling out issues of colorism as and when she experiences them. Years after the actor was replaced by Daphne Raid on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, for instance, Hubert pointed out to the Los Angeles Times that colorism regarding their different skin tone was evident from the get-go. "I'm called dark-skinned Aunt Viv," she explained. Raid is called light-skinned Aunt Viv. Before she left Fresh Prince, Hubert had even accused Will Smith of making colorist jokes on set, which she called him out on. Speaking to Black America Web, she alleged that the King Richard star used to tell "You are so black" jokes to the audience before the show, prompting her to come out and stop him. "One time, I was a dark-skinned African-American mother," she reasoned. "He didn't understand how unbelievably disrespectful that was to women like me." Hubert's outspoken stance on the topic led to some raised eyebrows in 2016 when Jada Pinkett Smith led an Oscar boycott, though seemingly done to protest people of color not gaining recognition of their achievements and not just for Will's Oscar snub. Hubert, regardless, rolled her eyes at the effort. Speaking to the Los Angeles Times, the actor suggested colorism within the black community of Hollywood had to be addressed before complaints about diversity could be made. She added, "It dilutes the movement when you only stand up for yourself." Ouch. Time is a healer, and after close to 30 years of one of pop culture's most fervent feuds, Janet Hubert and Will Smith finally made peace with one another on HBO's Max 2020 reunion special for The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. For Vanity Fair, the two aired their grievances, with Smith confessing to having made the set very difficult for his co-star before acknowledging that he was not sensitive or perceptive toward her pain. Just a year later, and Hubert's fortune had greatly changed, with the star being offered some really wonderful roles since the reunion. In an October 2021 Instagram post, she wrote, "Clearing my name from all of the drama has brought me peace and respect and also apparently friendship." Speaking to People, Hubert shared that she and Smith now have a very good relationship and text each other back and forth all the time. Considering their history, it's easy to imagine that Hubert may have struggled to accept Smith's apology. But according to Hubert, it was very easy. The actor told ABC7, "I felt the honesty, I felt the change. He's not the same person that he was at 21 years old." And just like that, it seemed Janet Hubert was able to undo the curse that had unjustly plagued her life and acting prospect for a great portion of her career. "If there are tree roots in the drain, the water does not flow," she poetically told People about her potential comeback. "The drain has been snogged." Thanks for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.